Hello kids, hello children, good afternoon to one and all. So in today's session, we are going to learn in deep about the divisions of Himalaya according to its region, base by keeping the base of the Himalayan ranges from west to east. We are going to divide the Himalayas into several parts there, as well as in the several names. So in the last session you have learned already about Himalayas. Okay, what is the range, how many kilometers, what is the width, from where till where the Himalayas has been covered in our country, yes or no? So in the last class, with the help of map, I have shown to you people. So once again I'm showing to you people about the I'm going to recap the content there. Okay, so you can see arrow mark here, and I'm showing just it. So this part is covered with the Himalaya. So this division is according to the longitude. Okay, based on longitude, we have divided the Himalayas into three parts. One is Himadri, that we call it as a greater Himalayas or a inner Himalayas. So the second one is the Himachal, that we call in the name of lesser Himalaya, or a second part of Himalaya there. Third one is the Shivalik. It is the foothills of the Himalayan ranges. It is the last part of the Himalayan ranges that we call in the name of Shivalik there. So this was the based on longitudinal divisions. In today's session, we are going to learn about the Himalayas have been divided base region from west to east. By keeping the base of the region, we are going to divide the Himalayas into several names there. Okay, so according to that one, a part of Himalayas lying between the river Indus and the river Sutlej. These two rivers are flowing in our country. So whatever region will come under these two region, we call in the name of Punjab Himalaya. Okay, so the next category of the division, the part of Himalaya lying between the Sutlej River and the Kali River. Kali River is also flowing in our country. So that region which covered the Sutlej and the Kali River, that region we call in the name of Kauman Himalaya. So next one is the Kali River. Kali River and the Tista River. River divide the Nepal Himalayas, and the part lying between the Tista and the Dihang rivers, that region we call in the name of Assam Himalayas there. So the Himalayas bend sharply to the south and spread along with the eastern. Okay. Eastern boundary of India. Okay. The Brahmaputra River, where the Brahmaputra River is flowing now. So the Himalayan ranges slightly they have bent there. Okay, we will see a little bit sharply they have been bended. So as a result, in the southern part, along with the eastern boundary, what is there, the boundary between India and the China. So between that one boundary is there now. So that boundary is known as the Purvanchal range. So this Purvanchal range is having some of the famous hills. So the Purvanchal compromises some hills like Patkai Hills, Naga Hills, Manipur Hills and Mizo Hills. So based on the region, we have divided Himalayas into Punjab Himalaya, Kauman Himalaya, Assam Himalaya, Nepal Himalaya and Purvanchal region. So this division is according to the, by keeping the base of region there. So moving further in the session, that is the northern plains. So the next categorization of physiographic divisions of our country is northern plain. So the northern plain had been formed by the interplay. So in the northern plain, the three major rivers are flowing. So those rivers are Indus, Ganga and the Brahmaputra. So these three rivers with its tributaries, it is flowing in our country. So as a result, the northern plain, the entire northern plain is formed by these three major river system, which is that region we call it as a northern plain there. So this plain is formed by the alluvial soil. ओके दिस रीजन वी कॉल वी इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द ऑलुवियल सॉइल. सो हाउ मच किलोमीटर इट हैज बीन स्प्रेडेड इन आवर कंट्री मीन्स नियरली इट स्प्रेडेड 7 लाख स्क्वेयर किलोमीटर. ओके सो दीज प्लेन्स आर अबाउट 2400 किलोमीटर लॉन्ग. ओके द लेंथ ऑफ द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन इज 2400 किलोमीटर. सो बिटवीन 240 and 330 किलोमीटर ब्रॉडर. ओके दैट वी कॉल. सो इन दिस नंबर एज वेल एज इन दिस सर्टन किलोमीटर्स द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन हैज बीन स्प्रेडेड इन अवर कंट्री. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर 1 मार्क्स दे मे आस्क द नेम द रिवर सिस्टम विच इज फॉर्म्ड द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन दैट इज इंडस गंगा एंड ब्रह्मपुत्र इन येल्लो कलर आई हैव इंडिकेटेड इट. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज द So next on what is this length, what is the everything, sorry, length, breadth as well as how many square kilometers it has been there, I have explained it. Okay, moving further, so this is the basic information about Northern Plain. So this region, we call it as a densely populated. Okay, this region we call it as a densely populated due to the fertile soil, adequate water supply, favorable climatic condition and terrain there. Okay, why we call it as a densely populated area? What is the reason behind why the most of the people they are they feel to live in such kind of area? Okay, so certain favorable conditions have been there. So you have already learnt as well as you have already saw that in the northern plain the 3 major rivers are been flowing with its tributaries. So abundance of water is adequate, that is abundance, as well as more water supply is there in that region. So most of the people, wherever they will get the more and more water, they will try to live in that area only. And due to the river course, whatever land part will be there beside the river bank as well as nearby the river bank, the soil will be too much fertile there. And it will be favorable for the agricultural activities. They can start some economic activities in that area. And climatic condition, temperature will be favorable to that condition as well as that situation where the rivers are being flowing, as well as terrain is there, like mountains, small hills are being there. So as a result, so these are the consequences as well as these are the situation where the people live, they want to live in such conditions there. So that is why the region will the region that come under the northern plain is mostly populated area. Densely means more population, most of the people they will live in that region only. Terrain means I have told about a field as well as Kannada na kshetra anta heltevi or a stretch of land, we call it as a terrain. So the rivers originating from the northern mountains slow down due to the gentle slope with result in the formation of riverine island. So in the northern plain we will see a unique feature. Okay, so in the northern plain we will see the unique feature called the rivers, whatever it is originating from the northern mountains slow down due to the gentle slope. A slope, a kind of slopey area is there, so which result the formation of riverine island. So it covers, you all know what is the meaning of island there. Okay, so among those, one of the famous island, riverine island, is there in the world as well as in our country, called Majuli. Majuli, it is situated near the Brahmaputra river, so that we call it as a inhabitant. Sorry, Okay, Majuli in the Brahmaputra River is the largest inhabitant riverine island in the world. So the rivers that in their low course split into the numerous channel. So think that the river is flowing and it is splitting into the number of channels like tributaries. Okay, and deposit due to the deposition of silt. So these channels are known as the distributaries, where we will see in the most part in the northern area only. So the northern plain is broadly divided into three sections there. Okay, so those three sections we are going to learn in detail in the today's session. First division, as well as the first part, is the Indus and its tributaries. Okay, that region we call it as a Punjab plain. Okay, these are the three parts based on river. By keeping in the mind of river and its tributaries, that region, which region we will call, they have kept a name for that one in the northern plain. Okay, so the Punjab plain, it is situated in the western part of our country, and it has been formed by the Indus River and its tributaries. So the large part of this plain lies in the Pakistan country, and the Punjab plain is also dominated by the Doab. Doab means nothing but two rivers, as well as two stream of rivers are flowing. So that kind of region, we call it as a Doab region. So Doab, it is made up of two words called Do means two, Ab means water. Similarly, Punjab. Why we call it as a Punjab plain? Why, ma'am, why we are calling? Because large part of the plain lies in the Pakistan. Means why we are giving this name means us. Reason is there behind. Okay, Indus is having its five tributaries. Okay, according to that one, similarly in the ancient time, they used to call it as a Panch. Panch means five. So in that area, the five rivers are flowing, means Ab means, you all know, that is water. So five rivers, as well as five tributaries, are flowing in that region, means that the people were calling in the name of Punjab. Okay, so as a result, that plain came to be in the name of Punjab there. So the next one is the Ganga plain. It is situated in the middle part of our country, as well as middle part of the plain. So it starts from the Ghaggar river and end towards the Tista river, and some of the states will come under this categorization, as well as in this category. So that states are Haryana, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, some parts of Jharkhand, and some parts of West Bengal there. And also this Ganga plain, it is too much fertile land, because the Ganga river is having its own tributaries. Those tributaries are flowing in the northern plain there. Okay, the slope gently, the slope area gently, it will turn towards the easternwards, and has the high fertile land. So it is agriculturally the most important region in our country. So because of too much fertile land and abundance of water is available in the Ganga plain, so as a result, the people, those who are living in that region, they will try, they will prefer more agricultural activities, and they will grow more and more food there. So as a result, whatever conditions I have told in the northern plain, so those conditions are being applied in the Ganga plain. The people, most of the people, they are situated in the Ganga plain only, and it is very high populated area, and some major cities are there on its bank. You all know Haridwar, you all know Banaras, or Varanasi. It is situated on the banks of river Ganga. So in this way, most important pilgrimage centers are being there, as well as most important cities are being situated in the river, on the river banks of Ganga plain there. So as a result, due to the abundance of water availability, favorable climatic condition is there, stretch land is there, plain area is there. So people will prefer more to be in such kind of land and do the economic activities. So as a result, Ganga plain, as well as the Ganga region, is having the high populated area, and some major and important cities are being there on the banks of river Ganga there. So the next categorization of northern plain is Brahmaputra river. It is the eastern part of our country. It extends from Assam to Bangladesh. So the next categorization of northern plain, on the basis of region, we are going to divide the northern plain into four parts. One is Babar, second one is Terai, third one is the Bhangar, and fourth one is the Khadar. So these are the four types based on the regions there. So first one is the Babar. After descending from the mountain, the river deposits the pebbles. Pebbles, you all know, some stones in a narrow belt. Narrow means a little bit thinner side will be there, as well as some broadness will be some, not as only some extent we will see some broadness there. So you all know the meaning of narrow. Okay, so after descending from the mountain, the river deposit pebbles in the narrow belt from 8 km to 16 km width, lying the parallel to the slope of Shivalik range. That kind of belt, as well as that kind of area, we call it as a Babar belt in the northern area. Next one is the Terai. It is in the southern part of Babar belt. Streams and the rivers re-emerge and create a wet and swampy and marshy region is known as the Terai. Before a thick forest, there was in the Terai region. So due to the migrant laborers, due to the people, those who migrated from one place to another place, they have cleared the forest. Some part of area in the Terai region has been cleared there, and they started doing the agricultural activities. But some parts in the Terai region, still some densely forest are been there, and it has been protected already by the localite people only. So among those, Dudhwa National Park is one of the park which is located in the Terai region. So the next categorization is Bhangar. Bhangar is the large part of the northern plain consisting the older alluvial soil. The Bhangar, the another name of Bhangar is old alluvial soil. It presents in the terrace like a feature and contain the calcareous deposit known as kankars. Kankars means, as well as calcareous means, small piece of stones. Okay, the soil is having small pieces of stones that we call in the name of kankars there. So next one is the Khadar. Khadar is situated in the lower region. The lower region is the flood plain, is known as the Khadar. Okay, the soil is renewed whenever there is a flood every year. Okay, the Khadar, the another name of Khadar region is the new alluvial soil, as well as the presence of that soil, we call it as a new alluvial soil. Why we call it as a new alluvial means, due to the flood activities are more in that region. So always the we will see the renovation of soil and a newness of soil will be there. Okay, every year we will see the formation of new soil. So as a result, whenever there is a flood, so this area will become most fertile, and it will be there for the best for the intensive farming. By using the modern method of farming, they can do the intensive cultivation as well as intensive agriculture in the Khadar region there. So on the basis of region, we have divided the northern plain into four parts, and the basis of river, we have categorized the northern plain into three parts there. So you have to remember, we may ask for 3 marks as well as we may ask for 5 marks. We may ask about difference between Terai region and Bhangar region, Bhangar and Khadar. So in this way, we can ask the differences for the annual examination as well as for your further exams also. And also I have told, for 1 mark, so you have to remember the 3 rivers as well as how much kilometers the northern plain has been spreaded in our country. So in this way, you have to remember some of the points there. I hope today's class you have understood about northern plain and another divisions of Himalayan mountains in our country. So in the next session, I am going to discuss about peninsular plateau, some of the islands and some of the coastal area which is situated in our country. So signing out, have a great day. Bye everyone.